Good evening everyone, welcome to Mahalakshmi Academy. In the last video we had seen how we could draw beams, columns, slabs and how we could assign properties to them. In the first video we had seen how we could define material as well as section properties in frame section, beam, column, also as well as slab. So we will proceed further and we will see how we could trim, extend and further thing. So for a while I will choose draw a beam. So at a distance, at any distance, we will draw one beam from here. Okay, we have drawn this beam. Now suppose I have drawn this beam and I want to divide this slab. So I will just select the beam and select the slab. Okay, go in edit, edit cells. Okay, edit cells, divide cells. Here we could see first option cookie cut floor at selected frame object. Click on apply, click on OK. We could see the shell has been divided into two parts. Okay, now suppose I want to again join the shell. So I will just delete this beam. Now these are the two shells. So select these shells, edit cells, merge cells. Okay, these two shells has been joined together. In this way, we could either divide the slabs or we could even join two slabs. Okay, now suppose we want to divide the beam. So I will just draw two beam over here. Okay, this is one beam and I will draw another beam. Okay, these are those two beams. So suppose I want to divide these beams. Okay, so I will select this beam as well as I will select this beam also. Edit frames, divide frames, bracket intersection with selected frame and joints. Click on apply, click on OK. We could see these two beams has been broken. Suppose if we, and this also, suppose I want to just break this two and not break this two, this beam. So I will select this two beam, these two beams, edit frames, join frames. Okay, now what we wanted is that we wanted this beam to divide into two parts, but we did not wanted this beam to be divided. So we could first divide and then join these two beam. In this way we could join or break the beam as we require. So suppose now if you want to move or copy the beam, okay, so what we will do, so I have selected this beam. Okay, edit, replicate. In replicate, suppose dx, in dx x direction will be positive and y direction will be right direction will be positive and left direction will be negative. Okay, suppose now I have to move it. In this case it will come only dy. So edit, replicate, and y dy also upward direction positive and downward direction negative. Suppose I will type phi, click on apply. So we could see this has been moved upwards. Okay, it has been moved over here. We will just do undo. Okay, now suppose if we want it in downward direction, so I will type minus phi and okay, the object was not selected. Okay, click on apply. Now it has moved over here. We will again undo. Okay, upward direction positive, downward direction negative. Okay, just do undo and suppose I keep the distance as 2.5. okay, and I suppose I want the number 2, so I will just type the number 2. Click on, okay, just select, click on apply. Okay, these two bars are the distance between this beam and this beam is 2.5. again this beam and this beam is 2.5. depending upon the number we can also copy it. So I will just do undo. Now suppose I want, I will just delete these beams. Okay, edit, delete. Okay, now this is the beam and suppose we want it in radial direction. Suppose the angle be 45 degree. Okay, so we will just type the angle as 45 degree and type the number as 1. Okay, so click on apply, click on OK. Okay, this beam we have got at an angle of 45 degree. This is the copy of this beam with same properties, only the angle between them is 45 degree. So we will just click on edit and we will delete it. In this way we could arrange beams, copy, replicate, our particular angle also we could copy it. okay, dx right direction positive, left direction negative, dy upward direction positive, downward direction is negative. Okay, suppose now I will just delete this beam. I will show another part. Select the draw beam. We will draw this beam till over here. Okay, now suppose I want to trim or extend the beam. We have seen in AutoCAD what is trim and extend. Suppose I want to trim this beam, so I will select this beam, select this beam, afterwards I will select this point, okay, then I will select this beam, okay, edit, align. Fourth option, align joints to nearest frame or edge. So I will just move over here, click on apply. Okay, this has been trimmed because we wanted to trim along this line, so I have chosen this line third. Okay, now suppose I want the reverse. Okay, I want this beam extended to our head. Now we are saying trim, now we will say extend. So select this beam. Okay, after that we will first, let me select this beam. Okay, I have selected this beam, then I will choose point, this point, okay, I will choose this point, and then I will select this beam, okay, edit, align joint frame and so on, and I will again choose align joints to nearest frame or edge. Okay, now this has been extended till over here. In this way we could either trim it or either extend it. Okay, so in this video till now what we have seen, how we could divide the beams, how we could divide the slabs, how we could join the slab. After that we saw how could we divide the beams, how could we join the beams. After that we have seen how we could trim the beam and how we could extend the beam. So thank you everyone for watching this video. I request you to please like, comment, share and subscribe. In the next video we are going to see how we could apply loads. Okay, thank you everyone.